Hi guys, welcome back to YouTube channel Chemistry Live UG PG. So today we are going to talk about detection of extra elements like nitrogen, sulfur and halogens like chloride, bromide, iodide. So this will be highly useful for BSc and MSc chemistry students under CBCS syllabus. So I have a simple message for you guys. Please think for innovation, be creative, learn everywhere, anytime and help to learn others. So there is a disclaimer for this experiment. In this experiment, approximate data are used to give a flavor about the experiment and for better understanding to the students. If you carry out your own experiment, you will get your own original data. It may happen that the result may vary from person to person. So the aim of the experiment is detection of extra elements like nitrogen, sulfur, and halogens in the organic compound. What are the apparatus required? We need test tube, fusion test tube, mortar vessel, filter paper, glass funnel, wash bottle, Bunsen burner. What are the chemicals required? We need sodium metal, acetic acid, chloroform, chlorine water, dilute nitric acid, ferrous sulfate, ferric chloride, lead acetate, silver nitrate solution, sodium nitroprusside solution, ammonium hydroxide solution. So what is the systematic procedure we need to follow? So first we need to carry out preliminary examination of organic compound. First is physical state of the sample, whether it is solid or liquid. Okay, then we need to see the color, whether it is color or colorless. So suppose the compound is yellow, so that may be nitro compound or diketone. So that means that indicates nitrogen is present. So if it is yellow to red, then it may be quinine or azo compound. So that also suggests the nitrogen would be present. If brown to dark purple, it may be phenol or amines. So in the amine case, it may be nitrogen may be present. Then we need to test the order. So if it is fishy order, that means it suggests amines. So amine means nitrogen would be there. Then if it is pleasantly fragrant, so that may be ester. If it has characteristic order, it may be alcohol, ketone, aromatic hydrocarbon and aliphatic alkenes, etc. And if it gives unpleasant odor, it may be thiol, isonitriles and low molecular weight carboxylic acids. Then we go for ignition test. So take a small amount of sample on a copper foil or spatula and heat it in Bunsen burner. So if yellow and sooty flame is observed, then it may be aromatic and highly unsaturated aliphatic compound. Then if it is non-sooty flame, then it may be aliphatic compound. Then if it burn with difficulty or not at all, it may be halogenated compound or highly oxygenated compound. Generally, halogenated compounds are used as fire retardant, so that's why it would not burn. Then we have to follow the Lassaigne's sodium fusion test or method. So in that process, what you have to do? We have to take a small amount of organic compound, solid or liquid, and mix it with a small amount of sodium metal in the fusion test tube. Then we need to heat the test tube gently until the reaction is complete. The sodium metal will react and the element present in the organic compound forming sodium salts in different forms. Once the reaction is finished, we have to add distilled water to dissolve the content of the test tube and cross the test tube with mortar and pestle, and we need to grind here and filter that solution and transfer the resulting solution to a separate test tube known as sodium fusion extract. So once we get this sodium fusion extract, we need to do the test, different tests. So during Lassaigne test, if the compound has nitrogen, so it would react with sodium, so we can get in water sodium cyanide. Similarly, if sulfur is present, so that you can get sodium sulfide. So suppose halogen is present, so that would react with sodium, giving rise to sodium halides like sodium chloride, bromide or iodide. And suppose nitrogen and sulfur both are present, so that would react with sodium, that would give rise to sodium thiocyanate. So first we need to detect for nitrogen. So what we have to do? We have to take 1 ml of that Lassaigne's extract, then add few drops of ferrous sulfate solution, followed by few drops of ferric chloride solution. So a deep blue precipitate or coloration called Prussian blue will be formed. So that indicates nitrogen is present. So in the extract, Lassaigne extract, we have cyanide, sodium cyanide. So that would react with ferrous sulfate, giving rise to sodium ferrocyanide. And that sodium ferrocyanide will react with ferric chloride, giving rise to ferrofericyanide. So this ferrofericyanide is called Prussian blue or blue coloration compound. Similarly, we now go for testing for sulfur. So 2 1 ml of extract, add few drops of acetic acid followed by few drops of lead acetate solution. So in that extract we have sodium sulfide. So if sulfur is present, so that would react with lead acetate solution. So we can get lead sulfide. So this would precipitate as a black precipitate. So that confirm that sulfur is present. Again, we can take 1 ml of extract, that Lassen's extract, and add few drops of sodium nitroprusside solution. So this is the formula for sodium nitroprusside, Na2FeCN5O5NO. So that would react with sodium sulfide. So that would give you sodium thionitroprusside. So that is purple in color, purple or violet in color. So that suggests the sulfur is present. Then we'll go for if nitrogen and sulfur both are present in the compound. So in that case, the Lassen's extract would exist as sodium thiocyanate. So to that extract, we add few drops of ferric chloride solution. So that sodium thiocyanate would react with ferric chloride, giving rise to ferric thiocyanate. So that is blood red in color. So that suggests sulfur and nitrogen both are present. Now we'll go for test for our detection of halogens X. So 2 1 ml of extract, add few drops of dilute nitric acid solution and boil it to remove any excess sulfide or cyanide. Then we need to add silver nitrate solution. So in the Lassen's extract we have only sodium halide, so that would react with silver nitrate, giving rise to silver halide. So if it is AgCl, that would give rise to white precipitate. If it is AgBr, that is light yellow precipitate. And if it is AgI, if iodide is present, we can get dark yellow precipitate. And to the same solution, we need to add ammonium hydroxide solution. If it is AgCl, then white precipitate, so AgCl will be totally soluble. And if it is AgBr, light yellow precipitate, so AgBr will be sparingly soluble. And if it is AgI, dark yellow precipitate, so AgI will be insoluble in ammonium hydroxide. So this silver halide would react with ammonium hydroxide to give rise to AgNH3 whole twice X. Then confirmation test for halogen. So add a few drops of chlorine water and chloroform to 1 ml of Lassen's extract and shake well, and we have to observe the lower layer of solution. Then appearance of no color and positive test in silver nitrate solution give it so chloride is confirmed. If we get orange or brown color, that means that is bromide is present. If we can get violet color in the lower layer, then iodide is present. So in conclusion, from experiment, since we get positive test for nitrogen and sulfur and halogens, all the three elements are present in the given sample. So I will be happy if you guys subscribe to our channel Chemistry Live UGPG and get some knowledge. And this is also available in the website www.chemistryliveugpg.com. So this is a simple step towards e-learning, making life better. So thank you all for learning.